Welcome to our informative video series. Today we're going to talk about asthma. I'm convinced that almost anyone watching this video knows what it means to be asthmatic. But I wouldn't hesitate to explore what asthma is before proceeding. As published in the University of Rochester Medical Center's Health Encyclopedia, asthma is a long-term chronic lung disease that makes the airways react to triggers like allergens and irritants. This makes it hard to breathe. With exposure to triggers, these changes occur. These allergens and irritants causes the airways to become swollen and inflamed. They also tighten the muscles around the airways, and this causes more mucus to be made, which leads to mucus plug. All these changes narrows the airway. This makes it hard for air to go out of the lungs, and fresh oxygen can't get into the body as well. What causes asthma? Health professionals and medical experts with centuries of research in this field still do not know the exact cause of asthma. They believe it's mostly inherited, and as well depends on environment, infections, and they believe chemicals released by the body also play a crucial role as to what causes asthma. Exercise causes symptoms in many people with asthma. Symptoms can occur during exercise. They can also occur right after exercise. In some people, stress or strong feelings can cause symptoms. Here are things that can or may trigger asthma. And we are going to break them in 5 different categories. But remember, these triggers depend on circumstances and may vary from one asthmatic patient to another. 1. Allergens. 2. Respiratory problems. 3. Irritants. 4. Medication. 5 will be other conditions that may not be included in any of the mentioned categories. Here are allergens that can or may trigger asthma. Pollens, like trees, grasses and weeds, can trigger asthma. Also, mold, pets, dust or dust mites, cockroaches and mice, dewar as well can trigger asthma. Here are respiratory problems that will or can in some cases trigger asthma. Nasal allergies, sinus infections, flu, and viral infections, such as the common cold. These are irritants that can or may trigger asthma. Strong odors like perfumes, cleaners, cooking, paint, and varnishes. Chemicals, for example, gases, fumes, air pollution. Changing weather, such as temperature, barometric pressure, humidity and strong winds, any form of toxic smoke like from tobacco, either directly inhaled or secondhand smoking. Here are medicines that have been well documented that triggers asthma. Aspirin. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, such as ibuprofen and other drugs of similar chemical composition. Here are other conditions that can be included in the above categories that can or may as well trigger asthma in a patient. Gastroesophageal reflux. Sleep apnea. Being overweight. Depression. Exercise, specifically in colder weather. Strong feelings that go along with laughing or crying. Now let's see who is most at risk for asthma. Asthma is maybe common in children and teens between the ages of 5 to 17 living in cities. Children with a family history of asthma. Children who have allergies or atopic dermatitis. Children exposed to secondhand and tobacco smoke. Other factors that can make anyone be at risk for asthma include personal or family history of asthma or allergies, and smoking or exposure to secondhand tobacco smoke. How can one know they have asthma or that they're asthmatic? Symptoms of asthma may include trouble breathing or shortness of breath, chest tightness, wheezing, or a whistling sound when breathing, coughing. Breathing becomes harder and may hurt. Talking and sleeping may be harder with severe symptoms. How is asthma diagnosed? The process will be your healthcare provider asking about your health history. He or she will give you a physical exam. You will also have to undergo other medical tests. The most important test will be spirometry. What's a spirometer? A spirometer is a device used to find out how well the lungs are working. It measures the amount and speed of air breathed out. You may have other tests. These are done to check for conditions such as allergies.
Let's take a quick look on how asthma can or may be treated. Asthma treatment will generally depend on your symptoms, age, and general health condition. It will also depend on how severe the condition is. There is no proven cure for asthma. It can only be controlled by staying away from triggers and by taking medicines as prescribed by your healthcare provider to lower the risk. Watching symptoms is a key part of asthma care. so is knowing what to do if symptoms get worse. Experts advise making an asthma action plan with your provider to control it or to reduce the risk of asthmatic attack. What are the best medicines for asthma? The two types of asthma medicines are long-term control and short-term, in bracket quick relief medicines. Long-term control medicines are often taken every day. They help prevent symptoms. Quick relief medicines calm asthma symptoms fast, but they only last for a short time. You may take either type of medicine alone. Some people take both. Your healthcare provider should regularly check and adjust your medicines as needed. At first, it may take a few weeks for long-term control medicines to work. You must take these medicines every day. These medicines include: Number 1. Anti-inflammatory medicines which will reduce or prevent airway swelling. 2 will be bronchodilators, and these will help relax muscles around the airways. 3 is leukotriene modifiers. These block the action of chemicals called leukotrienes. These are chemicals that cause airways to be inflamed and narrowed. 4 is anti-IgE, in bracket, omalizumab. This medicine reduces allergic reactions. It is an injection given 1 or 2 times a month. It is often used when asthma is harder to control. Finally, number 5 will be anti-IL-5, in bracket, interleukin-5 agents. These are given by injection as well in a health provider's office. They block a chemical in the body called IL-5. We strongly advise visiting your healthcare provider regularly. And please don't indulge in unprescribed self-medication. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe for more amazing and informative videos. Peace and love.